The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. It seems to me, said Mr. White, that the future is not a unified dream, but a miracle pie, long in the baking, never quite done. It does seem that way, doesn't it? But we all know that eventually the pie will have to be done. Not necessarily because it's ready, but quite simply because the oven shall have burned out.
The Council of Elders has been forced to make a decision. We must commit murder.
Murder? What is that?
We must end a life.
But a life can only end when the time comes.
Life can be taken from the body.
Who? Who among us could take life from a body?
You.
Never.
Not now. But you could be programmed.
Please. Why me?
You have been chosen by the computer.
Our mystery drama, The Golden Girl, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Gordon Heath and Earl Hammond. I'll be back shortly with Act One. The future is shaped by the thoughts and the deeds of every single human being. Everything becomes part of the unfolding design. The feathered wings of the ancient Greek inventor Daedalus evolve into the space capsule of the modern astronaut. Well, our story today begins in a large and crowded auditorium. A tall, dynamic, middle-aged man is holding his audience spellbound.
Yes, I am the messenger, Lawrence. And you may ask, the messenger from whom? I reply, I am the messenger from the power. The power that has created this universe. The power that rules this universe.
Speak the message.
The message? You have fallen into sloth and sin.
Oh, speak the message.
Abomination and error.
Yes, yes, we have, yes.
Therefore, you will listen to my message.
Yes. Oh, speak it.
There must be order.
Order.
There must be discipline.
Discipline.
There must be obedience. Order. Discipline. Or shall I tell you what there will be?
Oh, tell us.
Or there shall be punishment. The power speaks through me. Listen. I am the messenger. The messenger, Lawrence. Order, discipline, obedience. Say it. Say it to me. Raise your voices.
Elwood.
Yes, messenger.
Did I reach the people?
You were magnificent.
No, Elwood, I was not magnificent. It was the power.
Oh, no. It was the power shining through you, messenger.
I have now rested. Are the people still waiting?
Not a soul has left the hall.
Then I shall return.
Let me adjust your robe, messenger.
Have the penitents been assembled?
Yes, messenger.
And?
A half dozen have been chosen for your personal healing.
Good. Come. I feel the power.
The first one is rather interesting.
Yes.
I chose her because in her written report, she relates that she has never been able to speak, and so she has come to you for the miracle.
If it is the will of the power to cure her, she will be.
I also chose her because I believe she will make a most unusual temple priestess. She's tall, slender, and she appears to be made of gold.
Gold?
And there seems to be a shining quality in her face. She has a beauty that is breathtaking.
Come, The power surges within me. I know there shall be a miracle. My people, it is time for the healing. It is time for the power. And here is our first penitent. What is your name, my child?
Messenger, may I speak for her?
Speak, and may the power hear.
She has written these words. I desire the healing touch of the messenger, Lawrence. Since my birth, I have known only silence. Medical science has been unable to give me a voice. I appeal, therefore, through him. Let the power give me speech.
We have heard the request of this magnificent young woman. Truly a golden girl. See how the glow of goodness and purity shine in her face. Surely the power shall grant this prayer that comes directly from the heart. Step forward, my child, and let me touch you. Now...
No! No, stop her! Oh, no! No!
An up-to-the-minute recap of today's unbelievable story. The messenger Lawrence was shot and killed just a few minutes ago in the Temple of the Power by an unknown woman. It happened suddenly before several thousand of his devoted followers. At this point, nothing is known of the woman who killed him, except that she posed as a penitent and that she is described as spectacularly beautiful. She is now in police custody. Thus abruptly ends the career of this charismatic but controversial figure.
Thank you, guard. I'll call you when I want you. Oh, how do you do? My name is Stillman, Arthur M. Stillman. I'm here because I've been appointed by the court to serve as your counsel. You, of course, have the right to choose your own, but... Evidently you didn't, so, well, shall we get to it? Look, ma'am, if you don't want me to represent you, just say so. But I assure you I am quite competent. May I ask you something? Are you determined not to talk to me? Then look, I'm your lawyer. Now, sooner or later, you're going to have to talk to somebody.
I killed... another human being?
yes, that's what this thing is all about.
I committed murder.
Yes, that's why we're here. So now, let's get to it.
I was able to do it. I was actually able to do it.
We should begin at the beginning.
I killed him.
We have already established that.
What will they say to me when I come home?
Well, the fact is, you're not going home. I mean, for a while, at least. And if we don't get to work on a defense, you may never go home at all.
Oh, I shall go home quickly enough.
Speaking of home, where are you from?
Will my life be the same? Can it ever be the same?
Of course. I mean, after a while.
But... murder.
No. You'll see. People forget. You move away. You change your name. And so, what is your name?
Killing. It simply is not a part of our culture.
I can't agree. Sometimes I look around and I have to believe that killing is actually the cornerstone of our culture.
No. Your society, perhaps. But not mine.
I think you're in a state of shock. You seem unable to think clearly. But now, certainly you're in no condition to talk to me. Would you like to see a doctor?
Why should I see a doctor? I can monitor my own vital signs.
Well, obviously you're disturbed.
Of course I'm disturbed. I have committed murder. The enormity of it, I can think of absolutely no precedent.
Then you don't want to see a doctor?
No.
Look, what do you want?
I want to be left alone.
This is your late afternoon news roundup. Here we are, live, outside the house of detention on Sycamore Street. Here is where the killer of the messenger Lawrence is being held. Who is she? Where does she come from? Why did she do it? Everything about her is shrouded in mystery. All we know is that she has a kind of radiant beauty. She is like a golden statue. Hold it. Here's the man we've been waiting for. Her attorney, Arthur M. Stillman. Mr. Stillman, could we talk to you for a few seconds?
Yes.
In view of the tremendous public interest generated in this case, can you tell us something about your client?
No.
Why did she do it?
I couldn't tell you that.
Was she motivated by political or religious considerations?
I cannot comment on that.
Mr. Stillman, there is one thing you can tell us. What is her name?
Well, I'm afraid I couldn't tell you that either.
But surely, Mr. Stillman...
If you'll excuse me. Good morning.
Oh, yes. Yes. Good morning. Good morning.
Well, you seem to be in so much better spirits today.
Of course. I shall be leaving soon.
Leaving? For where?
Home.
Home?
You don't believe it?
You just simply refuse to accept reality.
Why must I accept your reality?
Oh, you mean there's more than one?
Oh, my dear. There are any number.
Now, look. You simply must talk to me.
You're very unhappy, aren't you?
Unhappy isn't the point. I'm charged with preparing your defense.
You must not worry about it.
Do you realize that you'll have to fight for your life? At the very least, your liberty.
I can see that you are an extremely sincere and sensitive person.
Yes, but I must know how I can defend you.
That won't be necessary.
Do you realize that within a month your case will be up for trial?
But in a month I shall not be here.
Oh, please.
I am quite disturbed by the fact that you're so unhappy.
But you can fix that.
Tell me how.
Just tell me who you are and why you killed him. See, that'll make me happy.
No. If I told you those things, it would make you even more unhappy.
How did we get off on this happiness kick?
Happiness? Well, that's the most important thing in all the universe.
Happiness?
Happiness. Meaning harmony. Meaning peace.
All right. Now, why do you keep insisting you will not be here?
Because it's true.
Does that mean you plan to,
To what?
To commit suicide?
Never.
But you imply that you intend to escape. And when there's no other way...
Suicide? What a notion.
Well, I can't see any other way you could get out of here.
I shudder to think of such a thing.
Unless you're part of an organized effort. Is that it? Do you have confederates? Do they have a plan to get you out of here?
You must understand. Suicide is murder. And I can tell you this. Never again could I be programmed to commit murder. Never.
Wait a minute. What did you just say?
I said I could never again commit murder.
No, that's not how you said it.
Well, how did I say it?
You said, and I heard it distinctly, you said never, never again could I be programmed to commit murder.
Of course. That's exactly what I said.
What? But programmed?
Certainly.
I'm not sure that I understand.
Come now. How could you possibly commit murder? Unless you are programmed for it.
What do you mean, programmed?
Why don't we ask Mr. Webster? He tells us that program comes from the Greek, pro and grapheme, which means to write down beforehand. We also note that the word program, which commonly referred to a schedule of events, has now been given new scope by the introduction of computers. Isn't it odd how one of the oldest words in the world has become the mainstay of one of the newest sciences? But what has this to do with our story? The second act tells the tale. Mr. Churchill once described it as a riddle wrapped in a mystery, inside an enigma.
Speaking of the lady who is at the center of our story, how could we describe her? Certainly she's a riddle, a mystery, and an enigma. And we can also add a puzzle and a paradox. Do you realize that as we stand here on the threshold of Act Two, we do not even know her name?
What do you mean? Program.
Mr. Stillman, the best thing for you would be to call the guard, leave this place, and never return.
Do you mean you're discharging me as your attorney?
I should.
But you haven't given me a chance to do anything for you.
There's nothing you can do for me.
Well, I don't understand. You don't tell me anything, and then when you do talk to me, it's all in riddles.
I shall bring you nothing but trouble.
What kind of trouble?
You're in love with me.
How can you say that?
Do you deny it?
But I don't even know you.
I can tell by the way you look at me.
The way I look at you?
You keep looking and looking and looking.
We are sitting in a rather small cell. How can I not look at you?
It's the way you look at me.
Now wait. Just hold it right here. You keep getting off the subject. You come up with a provocative statement, and before we can get into it, you say something else.
You may not be aware of the fact that you're in love with me just yet.
All right. I admit I can't take my eyes off you. You are the most beautiful woman I have ever seen in my life.
Is that why you volunteered to defend me?
No, that has nothing to do with it.
You're a man with a kind heart, but there can never be anything between us.
Well, who said that
there is too great a distance? Our worlds are too far apart.
What worlds?
Do you know how far my world is from here? Well, it's not even part of this solar system.
What are you trying to tell me?
Isn't it obvious? We could perhaps bridge the gap in space, but what about the distance in time?
Now I know the defense. Why, there can't be any other. Insanity. All I have to do is put you on the stand.
In your briefcase, among your papers, is a calendar. You see the date? Today's date?
Look.
I haven't been born yet. Nor shall I be for at least 3,000 years. So you see, it cannot be possible between us. I wouldn't want you to be hurt because of me.
I just wish you would tell me what you're talking about.
Perhaps I shall.
Oh, finally.
And then you shall understand why you had better leave me. My name is Raya.
Raya what?
Just Raya. It's enough. I come from, we call it in your language, the word would be serenity.
Where is that?
You wouldn't know. If it were nighttime, I could point to the star and show you. It would be my solar system.
Look, I did... No. No, I'll just listen. No, I won't say a word. But just answer this. Did you say you come from another world?
From another world and another time.
Huh. All right. Why not? What have you got to lose?
It's a world of happiness.
Sounds great.
It's a world without crime, without violence. I didn't even know there were such things until I was programmed for this mission.
Said mission being to assassinate the messenger, Lawrence?
Yes.
Oh, great. We have one gang of fanatics declaring war on another.
You don't believe me?
No, you just go ahead. This is guaranteed to fly in the courtroom. What did you say the name of your world was? Serenity? It gets better.
Why won't you believe me?
Well, you know, you may have to do a couple of years, but it probably won't even be in jail.
I know why you don't believe me. It's because you have not yet evolved into serenity. You need thousands of years of evolution.
Serenity, huh? Well, all right. How do we describe it to the jury?
Serenity.
Hmm?
I told you. It's a world without crime, without violence, only happiness and beauty. Such beauty everywhere. There is no ugliness in our world. No sorrow, no bitterness. Indeed, I never knew what those things were until I was programmed for the mission. No hatred in our world. No blind anger. No corroding jealousy. No malice, no spite. Indeed, I never even knew what those things were until I was programmed for this mission. No quarrels. No conflict. conflict, no discord. I never even knew what these were. I was programmed for love.
Your name is Raya.
Yes, Elder.
Do you know why you were asked to come here?
No, Elder.
To save the world.
Save the world? What could possibly happen to the world, Elder?
Listen.
Order! Discipline! Obedience!
What is that, Elder?
Order! Discipline! Obedience!
What is he saying?
Order! Discipline! Obedience!
What do those words mean?
What do you think they mean, Raya?
I don't know.
Yes?
Oh, they frighten me.
Listen. Necessary.
Oh, what is that?
Raya, it's a power that is sweeping through the universe.
I don't understand.
These are people. Armed people.
Armed? What is that?
They have weapons.
I don't know what you're saying.
Planet by planet, system by system. They conquer.
Conquer?
Conquer and enslave. Each year, the armed people come closer to serenity. Soon, they shall invade us. How can we fight them?
Fight?
We cannot wage war.
War?
We have programmed aggression out of our minds and hearts. We cannot defend ourselves.
Defend?
See? You cannot even conceive of it.
But what do they want, these armed people?
He is spreading the gospel, I suppose you could call it that, of an ancient leader, this messenger Lawrence.
But what gospel?
Power.
Why is it so difficult for me to understand?
Because we are different. Over the centuries, all the emotions, the urges, the drives that distort or destroy serenity have been programmed out of our hearts and minds.
Why can't I comprehend what you're saying?
You will, soon enough. You have been chosen to perform a mission.
What is a mission?
The elders of our world have been forced to make a terrible decision. We must commit murder.
Murder?
We must end a life.
What do you mean, end a life? A life ends when the time comes, when the body has outlived its ability to...
Life can be taken from a body.
Taken?
My poor Raya. I can just imagine the feelings that are raging inside you. All of us, the elders, were forced to go through it. But there is no other way.
But who? Who among us could take life from a body?
You?
No.
Not now, of course. Not yet. You would have to be programmed.
Never.
Our only hope is to make a change in the past.
But to take a life.
To make sure that something evil, loathsome, a seed of eventual destruction, would not be planted.
But to kill.
Yes, we must kill the messenger, Lawrence. You must kill the messenger, Lawrence.
I have no right.
Or he will kill us all.
How could I?
My child, the technology has been unused for centuries now. But we have it.
I don't want to.
We can be transcended through time and space.
But why me?
Because the computer has... has spoken.
The computer.
Only you, Raya. Only you in this entire world of ours have the psyche that will accept the special programming.
Nothing you could ever devise or even dream of could ever make me kill.
The computer does not agree.
I'm to be sent back somewhere in space to end a life. That is what you're telling me?
Yes.
After I take this life, what becomes of me? Is that to be the end of me?
No, child. Of course not. After you have performed your mission, you will be brought back to Serenity.
How?
The same way you left. You will be transcended through space and time.
But how can I live here again afterwards? I'll be an alien. My home. My world. I will have lost it forever.
No, child. That isn't true.
But I should have taken her life. I shall have known violence.
After the act is performed, you will be reprogrammed. In a short while, everything that can disturb or destroy Serenity shall disappear from your psyche. And then you shall return.
Elder.
Of course, you are free to refuse.
What must I do?
Sit in this chair, my child. Amora, the straps.
Why am I being confined? I am not accustomed to it.
Look at the wall in front of you. What do you see?
A man's face.
Look at his face. How does he make you feel?
I don't know.
Listen to his voice.
I am the messenger, Lawrence.
How does he make you feel?
Frightened.
Look at his face. You fear him.
Yes.
There must be order!
You hate him.
I don't know.
You could kill him.
No. No.
Order! Discipline! Obedience!
You fear him.
Yes.
You hate him.
I'm not sure.
You could kill him.
No. No. I don't want to.
Order! Discipline! Obedience! Punishment!
You fear him.
Yes.
You hate him.
Yes. Yes.
Punishment. Punishment.
You hate him.
Yes.
Fear him.
Yes.
Then kill him.
Yes.
Hate him. Fear him. Kill him.
Hate him. Fear him. Kill him.
Again.
Hate him. Fear him. Kill him.
Hate him. Fear him. Kill him. In a frightening yet familiar way, this is the story of all the trouble we know in this world. All the trouble, all the problems, all the stresses and strains, the feuds, the fights. Without thought, we fear. Without reason, we hate. Without mercy, we kill. I shall return shortly with Act 3. The mind of man, said Mr. Conrad, is capable of anything, because everything is in it, all the past as well as all the future. Yes, Everything is in the human mind because everything can be put into the human mind. Everything that's good, as well as everything that's evil. And who we are, what we are, depends on how we control the mixture. Which is why some of us are saints, and some of us are sinners. And most of us hover somewhere in between.
Hate, violence, false ambition, violence, vanity, intolerance, violence, malice, violence. Do you hear me, Raya?
Yes.
You will go back, back there in time, across the galaxy, to the dwarf star Sol, to the third planet.
I understand.
To meet this man, the messenger, Lawrence.
Yes.
And you know what a weapon is?
Yes.
This weapon.
I accept it.
You know its purpose, how it is employed.
I do.
You are familiar with feelings of violence.
I am prepared to kill.
You know how to kill.
Yes.
You are ready to be transcended through time and space to perform your mission.
Will you stop jabbering at me?
It is well for you to understand the philosophy of your mission.
What is there to understand? He has to be killed. And that's all there is to it.
And you are sure you shall be able to without compunction?
I can kill him as easily as crushing a mosquito. What is he? Vermin. Trash.
And you are aware of why you must do it.
I am doing it because I want to do it. I want the joy of fooling him, of playing a trick on him. I want to feel the gun in my hand.
Raya.
See? It is made of steel, cold steel. But it sends red, hot, raging fires into the blood. This is death. And he will see it. Before he can cry out, move away, defend himself, he will meet his death.
Raya. You must control yourself.
In that split second, he will see his death. And then... I will take away his life.
Amora, set the transcender. She must go now. Right now.
Yes. I was programmed. Programmed. Do you understand?
Yes, of course I do.
My mind was seething, raging, all through the transcending. You can understand.
Yes, yes, of course.
But then, in order to get into the Temple of the Power, it was required of me to perform another evil. Deceit. There were thousands assembled. Hundreds clamored for his attention. And I used my body.
What?
The promise. The implied promise of my body. To seduce him. I was trembling with fear, hate, violence, as I was brought before the messenger. And then he touched me. And I looked into his eyes. My heart almost stopped beating. In his eyes was all the hate and violence that had been programmed into me. The gun was in my hand. The fire was in my blood. And there had to be the inevitable climax of death.
I understand.
Afterwards, I was empty of all feeling, of all thought, like a machine that has no more fuel.
Oh, big casino!
What does that mean?
It means there won't be a dry eye in the house.
What are you saying?
That is our story. That is our defense. A visitor from another world.
It's true.
Okay, yes, it could be true. You know, you look as if you could be from somewhere else. Yeah. Yeah, they'll even half believe it.
But I am from somewhere else.
Yeah, sure, sure. Okay, now, let's get to work. Now, you must really tell me where you come from.
But I have told you.
Look, we start all over again. Your picture, it's been on the news and the papers. It's been all over the media. A face like yours, well, somebody will be bound to recognize it. Now, the first thing you know, the prosecutor will say, Raya from the planet Serenity. Now, isn't it a fact that you're actually Gertrude Smith from Jersey City? Now, look, I have to be ready for that.
But I am Raya from Serenity.
Yes, but what if you are Gertrude Smith or Judy O'Grady?
But I am not.
Well, what if he has the documents to prove you are?
There are no documents.
Well, there has to be a social security number.
What is that?
You mean you've never had a job?
A job?
Oh, let us get elementary. There has to be a birth certificate.
No.
Now, wait, are you telling me you were never born?
We must not do this.
Do what?
Fight.
This isn't a fight. We're having a discussion.
But there's violence in it.
We only want to arrive at a meeting of the minds.
There's violence and anger.
Look, now, there is nothing personal.
This is how I was programmed.
Oh, come on now, will you?
From anger to violence.
Just
to
listen,
murder.
Listen.
The steps are logical.
Simmer down.
The way is programmed. Don't let me take it again. I can kill. I killed once. I can kill again. Right now. Right here. I can kill.
No. It's all right. It's all right. No one's fighting with you. Everything is all right. It's just fine. You'll see.
I don't know what's the matter with me. I don't know. The elder said I would be reprogrammed, brought back home. When are they going to do it? When? The elder wouldn't lie to me.
Oh, no, of course not.
He wouldn't break his promise.
No, never.
Oh, maybe he can't keep it. This kind of thing, it's never been done before. Maybe they don't know how to reprogram.
Look, I'll take care of you.
I want to go home.
Make the best of it. You're home now. Raya, we go to trial in 2 weeks. If I play this right, half the jury will actually think you come from another planet. And the other half will think you're nuts. But nobody will vote to find you guilty. Oh, what a trial that's going to be.
There isn't going to be a trial. I'm leaving.
Oh, now don't start that again.
Last night, it happened.
What happened?
The reprogramming. Finally. And now I can go home any time I like. Finally, I am Raya again. Raya of Serenity.
Okay, keep it up. It all helps the cause.
Would you like to come with me?
Where?
To Serenity?
No, I don't think so.
The reason I ask is because you're in love with me.
Well, yes. Yes, that's true, I guess. It wasn't hard to fall in love with you. You know, we've really been very close, and yes. I'm in love with you.
It's not much of a love right now.
Well, don't say that.
But it could grow, develop, mature. It could become the kind of love we know on Serenity.
Well, what kind of love is that?
The kind of love I'm afraid you're not ready for. Right now, there are other things inside of you that are stronger.
Well, what do you mean?
Ambition, vanity. I saw them on your face last night. I see them now. That's why I want to help you. That's why I could love you. I am going home. You may come with me. You will be reprogrammed in Serenity.
Just save that act for the jury.
Is it so hard to give them up? Vanity, ambition?
But your case is going to make me.
It will destroy you. I will be gone. You will be held responsible for my disappearance.
What are you talking about?
They will say you helped me escape. You then become an accessory to my crime. What will you tell them? That I was transcended back to Serenity? If they believe you, you'll spend the rest of your life in prison. If they don't, you'll spend it in an asylum. You say you're in love with me.
I am. When this case is over, I'll marry you. I'll take care of you for the rest of your life.
But you're the one who needs caring for. Oh, leave this foolish, dangerous, violent world. Come with me. Come to Serenity. No. I see you're not ready. I thought I could shorten the time, but that's not possible. I suppose you really need 3,000 years. I'm sorry for what must happen to you.
Nothing is going to happen to me.
Arthur, will you kiss me goodbye?
I've always wanted to kiss you.
It will be our first kiss and our last.
Raya,
I'll call you guard when I want you.
Mr. Stillman, can we talk this morning?
About what, Lieutenant?
Why don't you make it easy on yourself? The fact is, you did help her to escape.
The fact?
Well, the guard, Jerry, right down the corridor, he heard her say, "Will you kiss me goodbye?"
Yeah. All right. Why should you believe me? After all, I refused to believe her.
Do you want to give up everything?
She asked me to, and I said no. And in the end, I had to give it up anyway. And for nothing.
Doesn't have to be for nothing. You're a lawyer. You know how things go. One hand washes the other. You give, you get. How did she escape? Where'd she go?
She returned to Serenity.
Yeah. Jerry, I'll come back later. Meanwhile, Mr. Stillman, you just think about it. I mean, really think about it.
Think about it. I think about it all the time. Perhaps one day, when every single lingering trace of malice, hatred and violence is gone, perhaps I shall arrive there. I shall arrive at Serenity.
We don't know if he ever did, but then perhaps no one ever does. It could very well be that Serenity is not a place, but an idea, a challenge, a way of life. I hope things remain serene until I return in just a few minutes. They say the optimist believes we live in the best of all possible worlds, and the pessimist is afraid that this is true. But that's only if we assume that the world we know is the only world there is. Is there another one? Somewhere out there? Revolving around a star, just as we revolve around our own? And if so, could it be better? Worse? About the same? Probably. Our cast included Earl Hammond, Gordon Heath, and E.V. Juster. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
That was nothing compared to what occurred during the night.
Doctor! Doctor, open up! It's Mr. Walker!
It's 3 o'clock in the morning. What is it, man?
Come up on deck and you tell me, Doctor.
Well, wait till I get some clothes on. I'll be right up.
Oh, for the love of heaven, make it quick.
Right.
I'm afraid to stand watch alone.
Well, Mr. Walker, what's this all about?
What? Quiet, man. Listen, and you'll hear it.
I don't hear anything.
It came from the bow. A keening and a sobbing of a little child. And then it changed as I went forward to look. I swear it came aboard and went down below. I was afraid, but I followed it. Oh, Doctor, I tell you, it went right into the captain's cabin.
Mrs. E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.